Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding stability in the time of change, written by Rakesh Sood. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now in this editorial, in order to understand this, we will be learning three important contours. The first important contour is about learning what is meant by liberal order, and secondly, this liberal order as a myth, and thirdly, we will be learning the important contour of how to manage the face of uncertainty. Now, as far as this word liberal order is concerned, this is a word that recently is being used by lot of print media and lot of electronic media. Now, why this word is in use? This word is in use because Donald Trump, after his election, has been exhibiting the signs of uncertainty, in the domain of diplomacy. Now, according to Donald Trump, America no longer holds the responsibility to protect other countries. America is concerned solely about America. And this liberal order word has also come into being because of the increasing fundamentalism, because of the increasing nationalism, because of the forces blowing against globalization. And all this has unfolded, all this has yielded after Donald Trump became the president of United States of America. Now, according to author Rakesh Sood, liberal order primarily was coined after Second World War. Now, after Second World War, colonialism was done away with. After Second World War, imperialism was done away with. After Second World War, hegemony of one country over the other was reduced. After Second World War, we had witnessed the rise of institutions like United Nations. And we have also witnessed the institutions of stability in the sphere of economy, like IMF, like WTO. But of late, this word liberal order, it has also come into being because of the increasing economic instability. So there are two reasons. What we are witnessing now is actually opposite of liberal order. Now, what we are witnessing now? Now we are witnessing is the dismantling of the regional corporations. What we are witnessing now is the dismantling of the economic corporations. What we are witnessing now is the dismantling of the diplomatic corporations. So what we are yielding to? Now primarily we are yielding to uncertainty. And according to Rakesh Sood, this uncertainty is more dangerous in the sphere of nuclear weapons. According to Rakesh Sood, in the current phase of uncertainty, where we are not sure about who is going to control whom and how the things are going to work, how the economy is going to yield its results, how the diplomacy is going to yield its results. So the biggest threat to the humanity, to the mankind, comes from the nuclear weapons. Rakesh Sood primarily wants that countries like India and countries like Japan, they basically should come together and promote the idea of nuclear free world. They should also promote the idea of developing deterrence. They should also promote the idea of dissuading instability that currently the world is unfolding. Now, Rakesh Sood has also thrown light on the aspect that whole liberal order that came into being after Second World War was actually not that liberal. It was not liberal in the sense, because liberal means that all the countries of the world, they have the right. All the countries of the world, their values are addressed. Liberal means there is no hegemony. But this word liberal has been given more meaning to what it actually means. What it means? It means that the world that was created after Second World War was actually not ultra-liberal. It was not substantively liberal. It was only relatively liberal, because after Second World War, we have seen the hegemony of capitalism. After Second World War, we have seen the rise of the fundamentalist forces. After Second World War, we have seen the entire economic domain and the diplomatic domain being run under the diktats, under the orders of United States of America. So Rakesh Sood wants to give a message to the readers of how the stability can be promoted in the time of change. And he has only put forward one solution, that is India and Japan, like countries, could come forward. And another thing that he has put forward is about promoting deterrence. And he has also tried to focus on the issue of North Korea. Now, North Korea is a big danger to the world. And in tackling this danger, Rakesh Sood wants that United States of America should be putting up its missiles in and around North Korea. But putting missiles in and around North Korea by United States of America will actually create tensions between United States of America and China. So this editorial basically comes out with different kind of projections in the diplomatic sphere. Projections about if America will be doing this, what would be the result? If India and Japan would be doing this, what would be the result? So the basic focus is on how stability can be ushered in, how stability can be engendered. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-0000. And tomorrow we are conducting a workshop in Chandigarh on civil services preparation. In that workshop, we will be discussing A to Z of the preparation. Now, how the preparation for the civil services should be done. Now, every nitty-gritty would be discussed in that workshop. Now, all of you, welcome to that workshop. Now, before you come to the workshop, you are required to register for the workshop. So, this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.